stem and leaf plots, a la Shmup. Catherine R. Pillar lives on a plant stem. Cat's a bit funny about her leaves. She insists on numbering and arranging all her leaves into stem and leaf plot formations before she eats them. Unfortunately for Cat, every time there's a gust of wind, her leaves get blown out of sequence. Well, here are the leaves today, by number. Okay, before we get started, what in the world is a stem and leaf plot? Well, it's basically a way of organizing data, so you can see at a glance which values might naturally be grouped together. Like, say you got a room full of voters, and you want to know how the 20-year-olds voted, how the 30-year-olds voted, and so on. Well, stem and leaf plot will put each age range into a neat, nifty little box for you. Okay, so to make a stem and leaf plot, create the stem by listing the digits with the largest place value to the left of a vertical line. There we go. In this case, we have the tens place, 5 for 50, 4 for 40, 3 for 30, and 2 for 20. The remaining digits, those in the ones place, will be written to the right of the vertical line to create and organize the leaves. Now that Cat has finished organizing today's meal, she decides that she wants to start by eating the leaf with the median value. In other words, the number that is in the exact middle of all the other numbers. Well, to find the middle number, we can simply cross out one number from the top and then from the bottom until we meet in the middle. Well, sadly, Cat has found that the median lands between 47 and 45. She doesn't have a leaf labeled 46. So she settles for the next best thing, the leaf with the mean or average value. Well, to find the average, we just have to add the values of all the leaves and divide by the total number of leaves. All of them added together equals 760. And when we divide that by the total number of leaves, 18, it gives us roughly 42.2. Well, finally, Cat can lie down and try to sleep off her food coma.